My name is Marcia Barbosa, and I do love to collect curiosities. I am one of those people that navigate on the internet looking for animals, plants, communities that live in very difficult or different or out of my bubble conditions. And don't think that I start to collect curiosities thanks to the connectivity of the internet. When I was young, no computers by then, I look into encyclopedias, almanacs, everything telling me things that were out of my everyday life. And do you know why I collect curiosities? Because when I'm concentrated in solving problems with my equations, calculations, all of that, suddenly, from this network of curiosities, one appears and calls me with a smile voice, Marcia, Marcia, look to me. And suddenly, I understand the solution. You think I'm crazy, but I'm not alone, like the music. Maria Meyer was the second woman to get the Nobel Prize of Physics. If now it's weird to have a woman physicist, by her time was unbelievable weird. The newspaper have the headlines, Mother of San Diego got the Nobel Prize, because the only thing a woman could do at that time was to be a mother and a wife. And do you know why she got the Nobel Prize? Because she unveiled a mystery. At that time they knew at the nucleus of an atom, there are a certain number of protons that when it happens in nature, they are super hyperconnect. 2, 8, 20. They are known as magic numbers. So she came and told, the protons are organizing layers like shells, the shell model. And the shells, they have an inner shell with lower numbers, an external with more numbers, and more numbers. When we fit one orbital like that, they would be perfect and connected. Do you know from where she got this idea? Not only from equations, not only for a library and book and talk with super, hyper intelligent physicists. She got that for looking a ballroom of people waltzing. When people waltz, you have an inner circle in which everybody is spinning in the same orbital, and each couple is spinning around like a spin in a proton. Then you go to an external, and external, you have all this beautiful spinning exactly like the nucleus does. It's not that beautiful? And all that came for the fact that she had got this idea out of her box. Imagine now, if you have a working place with very diverse type of people, each one carrying their own external box. How much discovery, innovation can come from that? I'm also a physicist, a theoretical physicist as Maria Meyer, but instead of looking to atoms, I look to molecules. Actually, I look to a single molecule, that's water. Water? Such a simple element? Water is nothing but simple. It has more than 70 behaviors in which water goes in the opposite direction of the other materials. Let me give you an example. When you freeze any material, decrease the temperature, the material gets more and more and more tide, occupying less volume, gets very dense, and sinks in its own liquid phase. But water, when you decrease the temperature, water just expands. and then gets less dense, and as you know, ice float into liquid water. And why that's so relevant? Because when winter comes and you start to freeze, water will freeze from the top to the bottom, leaving life possible so we can survive. So nowadays, when you go to outer space, everybody looks for ice because we hope that you are going to find some water underneath, or maybe in the past there was some water underneath. My research group looks also to anomalies of water, this weird behavior, but not bulk water. We look at confined water, at nano-confined water. So what we look is when you pick up water and you put it in nanotubes. To have an idea, a nanotube, take a hair, slicing in 70,000 times, slice, 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 you get a nanotube. And you flow water inside the nanotube. And what water is going to do as flowing into the nanotube is that water is going to align and form this beautiful line and flow up to 1,000 times faster than would do if water at nanotubes would obey the normal physics laws. 1,000 times, people. We can create ways to have filters for water very fast with this so simple idea. But water also have a second thing that is funny. Water is a temperamental kind of molecule. It loves some materials like salt, but also hates other materials, that horrible organic materials that you cover your sofa. So when you split water in your sofa, they don't penetrate in the sofa. They just form these little bubbles that never you enter that horrible material for water. So one day, I was thinking, how can I combine flowing fast, good for filters, and having this love and hate for water? I was concentrating, simulations, equations, how can I handle that? So I can think about ways to solve the problem of lack of fresh water. As you might know, today in our planet, a number of people, one in each six people in the planet, live in places with super stress of water. What can I do to help on that? And when I was concentrating in that network, remember my curiosity network, emerged a little answer to my question, emerged this beetle. This beetle lives in the Namibia desert, and it has in the back, if you focus, you're going to see, little tubes. In the top of the tube, there is a material that loves water, but loves so badly water that transforms the water vapor from the morning in the desert in liquid water. And then, in the bottom part, there is a material that hates water, like your sofa. And then the water droplets just fall, and the little beetle is just open its mouth and drink water. When I look to that, I knew I have my answer. I have to build a beetle nanotube. A nanotube in which water will flow, but you have a part that loves water and a part that hates water. Let me do that. I went to computers, I did the simulations, but unfortunately, it did work that well. And the reason why it did work that well is that in the entrance was too narrow. So water vapor transformed into liquid water, but then was so happy to be in this part that loves water that would not go to the part in which the flow would be so badly. Then the beetle called me again, Marcia, look to me. And I looked to the beetle and I realized that it does something very special. The beetle have a large area for collecting the water, but just a small area to drink in the water. And that's not a tube, that's a cone. So I create the beetle nanocone. And the beetle nanocone in the simulations were able to transform water vapor into liquid water, enter in the cone, flow, and get collected in the other side. This technology is until now going evolving, and I hope a few years from now, I'm going to come back and show you a prototype. Meantime, if you want to innovate, collect curiosities. Thank you very much.